Hello, fellow citizen. I come here today to inform you that total atomic annihilation is imminent. Lucky for you, your family has served us for quite a while, and your reward for that is a very welcome and VIP pass into the nearby local vault, Vault 111. You should be very honored. While the nukes are going off, you will be in perfect protection, I assure you. You will be completely safe while all the radiation and all that good stuff is poisoning the air. Yeah. So, I'm just going to give you a rundown and find out what makes you special. Your special is different letters. S-P-E-C-I-A-L. Each have a different category. The S stands for strength, how strong you are. The P stands for perception, how well you're able to see, smell, and just overall, it's basically mostly about sight and being able to aim better and all that. The E is for endurance, how long you can keep going, your stamina, how long you can run, how long you can run, that's pretty much it. Oh, and the C stands for charisma, that is the surefire way to go. It comes to being a good liar. We all love a good liar. And the liar usually is who gets their way. Because if you are able to lie to someone so effectively that they believe you and trust you, then they will do anything for you, get anything for you, give anything to you, and help you in any way you need, and then later you can betray them. And the I stands for intelligence. The I is for people who are good at reading. You know, in the future, people like you who will be cryo-frozen, sorry, I'm kind of stupid, and I don't know how to speak, but you will be a lucky guess of the far future, where no one else will know how to read, but you, my friend, you will know how to read perfectly. Yep. So, all the books that are lying around, just for you. And that's where your intelligence comes in. You can read them and learn certain schematics that can help you. And overall, you know, maybe give you a settlement. I don't know what's going to happen to you, but I assume that's probably what's going to happen. Just a feeling. And the A stands for agility. This is for the people who like to run around, parkour, jump, climb. This is for you. And this makes it so you're able to jump higher and also also makes you more proficient at dodging, you know, like dodging bullets. Yeah, just the usual. But, you know, out there in the wastelands that are for sure going to happen, I can. Oh, well. I think a nuke's already going off. Let's hurry this up then. But yeah, you can dodge better. You can have quicker reaction. Almost as if you were in slow-mo. You can just kind of aim better with your perception and then fire at specific parts of the body because of your agility and how quick you are. Ah, and luck. This is something a lot of people will actually lean towards more, because out there in the wasteland, when you're in need of a gun, you're in need of the ammo, you're in need of the mini nukes, you're in need of the Nuka-Cola, you know, you're in need of the RADS pills, you know, whatever it is you need, and it will most likely give it to you. Even those old trash cans outside of most of the buildings will most likely get you anything you need. You're out of ammo and you're 45. Well, look in a trash can. You'll probably get it. Well, now that you kind of understand what being special means. S-P-E-C-I-A-L. Special. You now have the choice to put certain amount of skill points into these categories. The max amount you can have in each category is 100. So you can have strength 100, perception 100, and so on. So you get 23 points to begin with, and I'll let you choose any of them. If you want 20 strength, go right on ahead. You want 10 strength and a couple perception, and then a couple luck. You know, you can balance it out any way you want. You can put a perfectly even amount in each, you know, a few in each, and it's just really up to you. But before we get into that, I'm going to quickly explain what Vault Tech is. Vault Tech is the most technologically advanced underground system for living and, well, surviving total atomic annihilation, of course. That's its main purpose, because everyone knew this would happen eventually. And while you're under there, you will have a perfect amount of food, but that won't necessarily be an issue, like, ever. Because all of the guests, or, well, maybe not guests, but all of the welcomed families of the veterans will be cryo-frozen for a very long time to hopefully get past all of the wasteland time period, but just assuming that something goes bad and you somehow happen to become unfrozen into the period of the wasteland, then that's what this is all for. But I said, while you're down there, you'll have food, water, security, protection. We have a great protection force down there, security force. They will make sure you are protected at all costs. Just make sure you get into the vault before the nukes start going off. So, in your categories, how much strength would you like? Strength has a lot to do with how much you can carry, because you have a certain amount of inventory space, or a certain amount of weight you're able to carry. And that is a very, very big deal, let me tell you. So, I suggest to you that you take strength very important. Are you sure you only want 2 points into strength? You have 20. Alright. 2 points into strength. Before you do this, I just want to let you know you're going to regret that. Are you sure? 3 points. Okay. Better than two, but I still think that's an issue. Alright, so, in perception. This mainly has to do with how well you can see. So, you can see enemies from a longer distance. You can snipe better. You can aim better with, well, any weapon, but sniping is mainly the big deal when it comes to perception. Because it helps the snipers the most. So, this one doesn't necessarily matter because guns are kind of less important since they won't usually be available during a wasteland type of period. Okay. That's reasonable. That's reasonable. 2 points. I forgot what the E stands for. You didn't want anything in that category, anyways. Okay. It's perfectly fine. I don't think that category is very important, anyways. So, I'm just gonna add 0 to that. Category for charisma, like I said, makes lying easier and people will believe you more. So how many points would you like in that one? Ooh, 5. Okay, that's not bad. I haven't seen too many people do that though. So you've spent another 5, 5 plus 5 is 10, so you've spent 10 skill points, now you have 10 left. The I for intelligence, like I said, this is for the books, and being able to learn things better and craft things better, like maybe turrets, fences, walls to keep guys out of your base. Okay. I need 3 points into that. Okay. So, you have 7 more points to spare, and you have 2 more categories, the A and the L. The A is for agility. Lets you run faster, dodge better, and shoot certain parts of the body better. How many would you like in that? Like I said, the gun may not be as important in the beginning. So, just keep that in mind. Okay, so you don't want any. Okay. That's not a bad choice. That's what I would have done. So luck just lets you get better things out of garbage and stuff like that. You have 7 points left. If you want to add them to a category you've already added to, I can just add them back. But you have 7 points left, and you haven't spent any on luck yet, so would you like to put the rest into luck? Do that for you right now. Alright, so I have spent all of your skill points. Your luck is the highest out of all of them. With 7 points into luck, that's quite a large amount into luck, gotta say. But honestly, I think that was a good choice. I'm just gonna put my pen in my pocket if you don't mind. Now, how about you come to the vault now? Unless you're busy, I know maybe I can smell some of that food. What is that? Spaghetti. 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 Yeah. That's what I thought it smelled like. How about you come to the vault after you were done eating? Because the nukes are set to go off in about 20 minutes, so you better hurry up and finish that dinner, or else you may die. Well, good luck, Granger, and I will see you in the vault.